It's 10 years ago, 2012 to be exact. I'm being my on-the-go self that I typically am, wearing my favorite clothing brand, Adidas, the second largest sportswear company. One day, my world was flipped upside down.
We have recently been informed by The Independent, a news source of the UK, that one of the top sportswear companies, Adidas, has been accused of producing the London Olympic uniforms in factories throughout Indonesia, labeled as sweatshops.
Once I heard this news, I was so shocked. I began to research and research. I came across this UK news source called The Metro. It's an article of 2011 that explains what Adidas is planning to create the London 2012 Olympic uniforms. They claim that they're going to use recycled materials for all the gear of athletes, employees, volunteers, and the audience. Here I'm thinking, that all sounds great. Then I came across this video on a site called Labor Behind the Label.
Mei Ling works long, grueling hours in poor conditions with few workplace rights. In reality, she doesn't have the support of a union or a fair contract with no job security or sick leave.
Labor Behind the Label supports garment workers' demands by building a bridge between them and the brand. They make sure workers will find a solution if there's a fall through, and they highlight inconsistencies of brands that aren't walking the talk. Ten whole years later, Adidas still makes an appearance at the 2022 Beijing Olympics on Great Britain uniforms. Adidas holds themselves accountable for their labor efforts, and they have a human rights tab on their website, as well as they're part of the Business and Human Rights Center, which keeps them up to date and accountable for the standards they hold for their labor. Adidas isn't perfect, but neither are we. Let's remove the disconnect between who makes our clothes and who wears them. So yes, I will still wear Adidas, but I definitely will be more aware of the logo on my shirt.